If you're a brand owner or a performance marketer or an agency who are running ads for your brand on Facebook, then you know that creatives are the key. And in this video, I will show you how we do creative research for our brands at Adbuffs. So let's take a product known as maybe stretch marks removal cream or a cellulite remover cream, and let's do the creative research of the same. So for the very first step, what we'll do, we will be searching the stretch marks removal cream and check out what are different kind of competitors who are actually running ads. So go to stretch marks removal cream. I can see that, you know, there are multiple brands who are running ads. So I'll make a note of all these kind of brands in my spreadsheet. So as I can see, you know, there are brands like ThriveCo. So as I can see, like, there are brands like ThriveCo, then there's, you know, Rapid Repair by Conscious Chemist, then there's, you know, Chemist at Play, there are Be Reduce and many others. So also there is, you know, Bare Body Essentials, Be Body Wise. So I'll, you know, make a note of the brands who are, you know, running ads, and I'll also check, you know, the number of other, like, for example, there are brands, there are this kind of blogs as well, which, you know, give me list of the brands who are running ads in this sector. Now, once I actually have a list of all the brands who are running ads for this particular brand, I will go ahead and also check in Amazon that, okay, what are the brands who are in this sector and who are the leading ones. So let's go to Amazon. Search for stretch marks cream. Now here again I can see, okay, Thrive is the best seller. Then there is also, you know, Derma Touch, which is a new brand which I did not see in Google Ads, so I'll make a note of that as well. So in Amazon, you know, I can see other brands who are also running ads. I can see ThriveCo is a common one. Then there's a Derma Touch, which was not there in the Google Shopping, so I'll, you know, make a note of that in my deck. And then go ahead and search other brands. Okay, there's Mama Earth, then there's, you know, other, like, I feel is there. And one thing I can definitely see that in, as well as in Amazon, is that, you know, maybe pregnancy is really working well as an angle. So I'll make a note of that as well, but I'll, you know, like to deep dive into my ads library and see what are the kind of ads that these brands are actually running.
What I can also do is, anytime, suppose you are going ahead and searching a stretch mark, any kind of products, when you go in your Amazon, in the just below that, you will be also able to see that products related to this item. So with this comes, you know, Nigrifix is there, then comes, you know, Milo Care, then some other examples are also some other brands that I can see, which I'll also make a note to in order to save it. So if I go down, you will be able to see that, okay, so this is a product which is 14th in maternity skincare. So with this also gives me an idea that this product, the pregnancy angle is actually something that works very well in the stretch marks category. So I'll see this, I'll click on maternity skincare, and I can see, you know, multiple products who are also selling in this category. Now, based on the list, what I will do is I'll just go to their ads library and Facebook ads library and check the ads that are running by them in Facebook. So you can save all the reference brands that you want to refer in your bookmark for your ease to, you know, understand once you have a list of them. So just going back here. So in ads library, you can actually, you know, select India as a country or also all. If you're not, you are doing for international brands, you're also looking for brands who are running ads outside. Then in ads category, you can select all and, like, okay, let's start with one of the brands from the list. So let's start with, suppose, Chemist at Play. So in the ad library, okay, you can actually find in the Save to Foreplay in my ad library, which is also another tool that we use in Adbuffs
to research our creatives, and it's a very good platform for discovery as well as storing of creatives. So I will walk you through that also at the end of this video. So when I go to the ad library, I'm going to scroll down first and I'll see what are the oldest ads that have been running in this account, which gives me an idea. Okay, like these are the winning angles and maybe they are running for quite a long time. So the first thing I'll go is I'm going to scroll down. So the first ad I can see and the oldest one here is from 29th June. It's a before after ad, but it's though not directly for my directly for a stretch marks, but it's for swellenines. But I think this can also be done for stretch marks, which is a before after giving the number of by how many days the results can actually show. So I'll make another tab here in my sheet. And okay, so what are the kind of angles, communications? So it's first is showcasing before after. Then I see what is the communication that they're doing is it's stating that visible results in days. Now why did I make a note of this particular thing for even when it's not for my direct product? Because when I'm looking into ad library, I will look into all the potential creatives that can be tried out for my product. It may or may not be directly related to the product I'm looking for. So then coming to the other parts, here it's goodbye dark underarms. This is for let's have a look at this one.
Hi, I'm Devika. I'm an architect, and from the longest time I've been facing this issue of rough bumps on my legs, clogged pores, ingrown hair, and honestly, I've been doing nothing about it. Since my college time, I've been...
So again, I can see, this particular ad is running from 6th of July, and it's kind of a direct UGC. So again, that is something that I can definitely try, and I'll make a note of that. UGCs and starting with a pain point where as I can see in this upper ad as well that she was suffering from bumpy skin for quite a long time. So I'll just starting with the pain point will be my so I'll walk you like this. You can actually go ahead and see what are the different kinds of ads. So let me see some of the ads for the stretch mark screen directly now. So here's one.
Don't you hesitate. Put your record on. Tell me your favorite song.
So in this ad, they are actually, showcasing the application of the video, and it's kind of, just starting with how they are starting, they're introducing the product, and, because it's a new product, maybe they are introducing the product, and it's kind of an application video. So again, something that can be tried is definitely I'm going ahead with the application video. Introducing product is my claim. Introducing product. So though I'm I'll keep a note of multiple communications, I'll try to align my creatives with a framework that has worked for me maybe in the account. Suppose starting with a pain point has definitely worked for me because maybe it gives me better hook rate, so I'll definitely prioritize those kind of creatives in my account. So let's go and see other creatives for the stretch marks a bit more. And okay, so here comes the green screen video. And here I can also see that whenever I'm walking through the ad library, I will also see the number of same kind of ads that they have. So if there is many back, suppose this is another before after, there was another before after that I've seen before, then there are then there is review based creators. So the number of same type of creators, if I see in the account, I can get an idea that okay, these are the kind of creators that is really working well for them. Hence there are so many variations of the same. So I'll definitely check on those creatives which are working better, and I'll focus those on more for my account as well.
Is your acne preventing you from wearing cute dresses? This acne body wash by Chemist at Clay is a savior. It totally cleared acne and lightened my scars. It has 1% salicylic acid to fight acne and reduce breakouts without drying out your skin.
So again, this is a kind of creative definitely that I'm going to try. It has, first of all, it's having a very interesting hook line, very interesting thumbnail, which is, you know, starting with the back, like they're having a green screen video and they are, you know, showcasing that order now and see the difference in 2 weeks. So it's also a good thumbnail, so I'll, you know, keep a note of that as well for me. And then, you know, if I see the creative, so there are two variations of this same, so it's definitely an angle that can be used. I'll make a note of the same. So if I, you know, go ahead and similarly, okay, there's another us versus them, and I'll go ahead and let's check, you know, some other ad libraries. So let's take, you know, Thrive. Okay, so here again, I'll just scroll down and see the ads that they are running. Okay, so the first ad, I think the oldest ad that's running here is from 3rd May, and it's a new angle which is showcasing stretch marks due to pregnancy. So definitely, I think that is, and when I was scrolling to Amazon, I also saw that, okay, stretch marks due to pregnancy is an angle that has been tried there as well. So I think that's going to be one of the angles with which I'm definitely going to start, is, you know, it's a fear angle, because the stretch mark due to pregnancy is a fear. So while writing the communications, I will also keep a note who are my target audiences here. So whenever I'm showcasing, you know, before, after and visible in, so it's kind of an open and broad appeal for my products. Anyone who is suffering from stretch marks, when I'm having a UGC and starting with a pain point, that's also, you know, people who are, maybe it can be men, it can be women who are, you know, suffering from the stretch marks. Application video is also going to have a very broad appeal. When it comes to stretch marks due to pregnancy, it's directly communicating to the mothers, would be mothers, and, you know, anyone who is aspiring so to be a mother, and any woman who has just got married and they are trying to conceive. So coming to the ads library, so okay, this is something that I like to save in my library. Then coming to the other ads, okay, so I see, you know, there are variations where they're having a hook of, you don't need a tummy tucker to get a smoother, firmer belly. And it's, again, it's something I think is showcasing with belly fat. Let's go to this particular creative as well. Okay, so there's another variation of stretch marks due to pregnancy, which means that, okay, this is definitely one of the belly one. So let's see this. So again, this is, I think, a before after creative, which means like I already have this on my communication, but I can keep a note, and they are using some abstract backgrounds on the back end to showcase the animation, which means that this kind of ads actually has lesser chance to get rejected. Then coming to the other ads here. Okay, so if you see here, they are again having before after as a communication and showcasing the stretch marks. They're again using abstract angles. Here's another one, which again the a pregnancy angle showcasing the device transformation. So this is again something I would like to try, because it's an image and I think it's very easy to fast to make as well. Oh, then comes an offer based creative, offer and ingredient based. So this was something new to my list, so I'll, you know, make a note of that as well. So, you know, offer based creatives, and here, you know, it's showcasing directly the offer or the discount along with the ingredients. Then comes, let's see, the other ads. Again, there's a stretch marks. Again, they have also used another angle I can find here, is show off your gains, not your stretch marks. That means it's something related to their stretch marks to weight gain, which again it's a new communication, so I will kind of make a note of that as well, that you know, stretch marks due to weight gain, again it's a fear based and it's a stretch marks due to weight gain. So with this I can actually get to the male audience. Till now, you know, most of the products I wore, you know, on a female oriented, so male audience is definitely something who will be there. Also like women who are, you know, interested in, who are going to gym, or you know, they are having weight, anyone who is having weight gain. So this is definitely an angle that I'm going to try. And once I know, once I'm starting to get some ideas or the creatives, I'll, you know, directly start with this on my ads and align the creative team with the briefs and let's start while meanwhile, you know, doing more research. So similarly, I know I will like to go through all the ads that they have, as well as on another brand which I was seeing on the first was suppose, you know, Dermatouch. Dermatouch is also like something I was not seeing on Google ads. So I'll just go ahead and search their ads as well. And so here again, like, you know, I will walk through the ad library. I will follow the same and simple method repeatedly and search out the winning product, winning type of creators from my competitors. And why will we start with this is the only reason is if I know, you know, something is working well, what I want to do is I will like to make iterations and something that's already working in the market for my account first, and from them, once I get winning angles, I can actually make multiple iterations and create more and more variations of the same to scale it. So this is the first approach that I will go ahead and take, and then comes the next part actually where I will, you know, also walk you through how to go ahead and search for foreign brands and you know, look into brands who are also, you know, leading in this industry or experts. And for that I will walk you through Foreplay. So when I actually, yeah, Foreplay is a very useful app. You can actually save your ads, you can actually save your references and also search for brands and use it as a discovery platform. So if you go to Foreplay and go under discovery, here you can actually see brands, and from there you can also see how many of the brands, you know, I have saved, and there are some leading brands with which, you know, I'm definitely going to work and search. So suppose I'm going to Dr. Squatch, and I know this is a brand which I have good for the reference for thumbnails or hooks as well. So if I, you know, just see the kind of ads and something that can be done. So I thought I have bumpy arms forever until she told me. So okay, this is a good hook and also a good thumbnail. So it's having a split screen, which I did not find yet on the ads library. So I'm definitely going to save this one, and I'll just let's walk through.
I thought I'd have bumpy arms forever until she told me.
You want us to touch you? We want to touch you. Get some good soap on your body.
So okay, this is a very nice, like, this is kind of opening, you know, maybe I can target men with a communication for women, as well as maybe I can target women with a communication for men. So doing that kind of hooks where I'm directly telling that you can, I was thinking that I will have stretch marks until she gave me this, and then I will go ahead and, you know, start to replicate things that has been there on this ad, or also work with my video frames that I have already shared, and I'll also share a link. So okay, so this is another very good hook that I found, that it's also opening an angle of, you know, like cross gender, maybe male is looking for female and female is looking for the male one, and the hook as well as the thumbnail is something that is really which I would like to use on my account. So let's see what the
I'd have bumpy about. Arms forever until she told me.
You want us to touch you? We want to touch you. Get some good soap on your body.
So we did some research and this pine tar soap from Dr. Squatch popped up. Apparently it's specifically made for men. It's full of healthy ingredients like shea butter and sea salt. Oh, and actual chunks of oatmeal to help clean the dirt out of his clogged pores. But the best part, the entire bathroom smelled like fresh pine trees. After just like one or two showers, I could feel a huge difference. His skin felt so soft. He smelled...
So this is definitely a good ad, and if you see, it actually matches one of the winning frameworks which we have seen in Adbuffs, you know, showcasing the hook, then, you know, introducing the product along with telling the benefits, results and everything. So again, I'll just save this ad and we'll go forward. So this is how, you know, I can actually research in Foreplay as well. And any ads which, you know, I'm inspiring to use, I will, you know, just save it here. And not only you can go ahead and search for brands, but also you can, you know, search for experts, you know, and you can see what are the winning kind of ads that has been used by them in their ads. And that gives you more like idea of, you know, what are the things that's working well on the industry. So anytime, you know, you're starting with the creative research for any product, what I usually do is first I start and I suppose, you know, I make do intense creative research. I take around 50 to 70 examples of creators and first start replicating them for in my ads. And from them, you know, once I understand what are the things that's working well in the account, and then I actually start making variations, and with this also gives me own ideations as well. And whenever, and don't forget that whenever you're having any kind of communication or angle you're finding from your, you know, from the ad library, and you are making the creatives, so all the communications angle you're making a note, you can always use AI tools like ChatGPT, and you can just give them a prompt that, okay, give me 5 hook lines for stretch marks, and then you can also set it up with different kind of frameworks and walk through that. So there is some, that is something I'm going to show you in the next video, next part of the video. So stay tuned. Thank you.